نحمده ونصلي ونسلم على رسوله الكريم أما بعد
رحمه الله تعالى فخر الدين الرازي رحمه الله تعالى the great academic of the Muslim world great academic his book on tafsir at-tafsir al-kabir widely read by the ulama And each and every alim benefits from his book. And he left behind approximately 200 academic works for the Ummah. 200 academic works. And what does he say? He says that it is very regretful when the time for food comes. Because I will be wasting my time. Somebody who works so hard that he leaves behind 200 academic works for the Ummah, he says that it is very, very regretful. When I have to sit down and sit down for food. And how long did they used to take? Did they used to have food like we do? Starters and then the main course and then dessert and then tea. No, it was very simple. Simple. Very simple. A very pious saint was asked, her, why do you not eat chapati? Why do you not eat chapati? Why do you very quickly eat those things which you can just drink it with water? Why don't you eat chapati? So he said that once I sat down and I ate chapati in my meal. And I looked at the time. And thereafter I took this other option. Quickly mix something in the water and just drink it. And he said, I looked at the time again. And then I compared both the times. The time that was extra, that I had to give extra in chewing the chapati. He said, in that time I started reading tasbih. I wanted to see how many times I can recite Subhanallah during that time. So he said, I recited 70 times Subhanallah. So he said, I thought to myself, then why should I make a loss of 70 subhanallah at every meal? So from that time I left chapati on one side and I just quickly drink whatever I can. And in the remaining time I read tasbih so that in the hereafter I will be able to benefit. So friends, this is the message I want to give to you. Value time. Value time. We do not value time. We don't even feel sorry. We don't even feel regretful for wasting our time. Never mind just wasting our time in something that is not beneficial in the hereafter nor in this world. But we are wasting our time in those things which bring destruction in this world and the hereafter. Selling drugs, consuming drugs, fornication, adultery, consuming alcohol, backbiting, accusing people. These are not those things which do not bring benefit in the hereafter, not bring benefit in this world, but it does bring loss as well. These are things which will bring destruction in this world and the hereafter. It brings the displeasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So let us go from here with a firm resolution that inshallah we will learn to use our time correctly. We will learn to use our time correctly. We will make a timetable for ourselves and we will manage time. We will make sure that we do not do anything which is not fruitful in this world nor in the hereafter. We will do only that which is beneficial in this world or in the hereafter, remaining within the limits of Sharia. If we are able to do this slowly, slowly, if we make effort, inshallah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help. And if we do two things, number one, make a time table, manage time properly, hold fast to time. And number two, make muhasaba every day. Every day take reckoning of yourself. Umar ibn Khattab radiyallahu ta'ala says, Hasibu qabla an tuhasabu. Take your hisab. Before Allah takes your hisab on the day of Qiyamah. Take your own hisab every day. Every day sit down, think, what have I done in the last 24 hours? What have I done in the last 24 hours? What I did, was it permissible, impermissible? If it was impermissible, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. Oh Allah, forgive me, I will not do this again. If it was permissible, was it fruitful in the hereafter? Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah. Oh Allah, I am being grateful to you. Grant me the tawfiq to do more of these activities. If it was not fruitful in the hereafter, was it fruitful in this world? Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah. It was something fruitful in this world. Oh Allah, grant me the tawfiq to do more of this, and also more of that will bring benefit in the hereafter. If it was not fruitful in this world, that means we have wasted that time. Although we have not done anything that was categorized as disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but wasting time. Everything that is permissible is not to do. Time is not to be wasted in anything that is permissible. Oh, this is permissible, so it's okay. Oh, this is permissible, so it's okay. Anything that is being sold in the shop, you don't buy. You only buy that item which is value for money. So similarly, anything that is permissible, you should not do. You should only do that which is value for time, which is value for life. Al-waqtu aghla min al-zahab. Time is more precious than gold. Time is more precious than gold. Because if you lose gold, you may be able to acquire it after hard work and toil. But when you waste time, the time that is gone is gone. Ho rahi hai umr misle barf kam. Our life is decreasing, like melting ice, chupke chupke, rafta rafta, dam badam. Very quietly, slowly, slowly, second by second, it is decreasing. Use this ice before it melts. Because if you do not do so, it will melt away. And you will not be able to find that melted water. So friends, this is where I would like to end. Hasibu qabla an tuhasibu. Take hisab. So make a timetable for yourself. Manage your time. A lot of my associates and those people